Hi, my name is Nathalie Issa and I play Yusra Mardini in the Swimmers.
Hi, my name is Yusra Mardini, I'm the original one, and we are very excited that The Swimmers is out now on Netflix.
So today we're going to talk about some of our favorite scenes. So my favorite scene and the movie, like I love all the movie, I love all the scenes, but there's one in particular that always makes me emotional, is when Sarah comes to Yusra and tells her that she's going to Lesbos. Because it tells a lot about the sisterhood. It reminds me a lot about both my older sisters who, when they went away, when they choose their own path, it creates kind of emptiness. And like, because you're used to live with your sister the whole time and you have the same like routine. And then at some point you see them grow up and they have to go.
Are you the baby sister?
Yes,
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I'm the youngest. Oh. I play the middle actually, but now I'm the youngest. And it's so heartbreaking to see. I don't know. It reminds me a lot because you know when you go your own way, then everything changes.
Yeah,
and this is how I feel. Even when we were doing like the scene, we were crying, Manal and I, during the rehearsal because it's just so emotional.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, we cry every time we watch the movie, and I feel like. I understand what you're saying because like we all went our ways after arriving to Germany. You can see that like Sarah went back to Lesbos. I wanted to focus on the Olympics, and then Shahed was left with my mom. And so it's I know. I understand, yeah, because as an Arabic family, you live with your family until you get married. So it's going to Europe is something very different. Yeah, I understand.
So. Yeah, and you? What's your favorite?
One of my favorite scenes. I mean, obviously, it's my life story, so it's a bit confusing to have a favorite scene. But my favorite scene is me and my sister dancing on the rooftop. And then you can see the music. Obviously, was Titanium, and then you can see the bombing happening. It brings lots of awareness, and it shows people that there was war. Everything is happening, but we still wanted to have a normal life. We were just teenagers. I was 17. I was back then. I think in that scene, I was 16. We were still somehow partying. We were still going out. We were still trying to have a very, very normal life. And I don't like when I see in the news always this image of my country destroyed. And from the Arabic countries, basically most of them, they're shown that they are gray and destroyed and somehow.
Yeah, it's wonderful also in the movie because during the Syria scenes, it's all colorful. Yeah. Even if there's wars, there's always colors and it's always happiness, no matter like. And when they arrive to Germany, actually, it's all gray. Yeah. So I love this contrast, and that's what's wonderful. Yeah. The movie, it's all real. It shows things that you don't that people normally don't expect.
So and it's really both nice. Syria and Lebanon. They're very, very culture. Like the culture is amazing. The nature, everything about our countries is amazing. So I love that the movie portrays that. Yeah.
We can also see the colors also like during the Rio scenes, like and
what the pool is blue.
You know, it's like because you go back to the water, your dream is coming true.
Of course,
So how was it to like finally go swimming in the Olympics?
Honestly, it was very emotional to watch the movie because like lots of real footage from the real Olympics that Netflix apparently or working that it got, and I was very surprised. It was really nice to just see it again and to realize, okay, I really did achieve my dream. I've been swimming since I was 3 years old, and let me tell you, I did not like it all the time. It was hard. Sometimes I was crying. Sometimes I felt, when the war started, I felt like I will never reach my dream. And I you can see in the one scene in the movie where the pool is being bombed, and this happened in actual life, and that's, it's just sad that became normal life. And at that moment in the war, I felt like my dreams are very, very far away from me and I will never get to be an Olympic swimmer. And going to Germany, meeting Sven, and then telling him about my Olympic dream, then somehow getting a scholarship from the ISC, and after that, being a part of the first ever refugee Olympic team. You saw, I was struggling as well. I didn't accept it very quickly. And I was like, I do not want to be at the Olympics because people felt sorry for me. I want to earn my spot at the Olympics. And I think you felt that too because, you know, when I entered the stadium, it was actually in real life, it was amazing. And it was a moment for me where I realized this is not only your dream, this is not only about you anymore. It's about millions of people. You're representing people who needs the hope. people who need your voice. So I am gonna swim for all of them.
When you did the Olympics, you won your first heat.
Yeah.
Were you thinking of all of this, about all of these people?
Honestly, every time I swam any race after everything that happened, I always thought of refugees. I always thought of them, and I always thought, you know what? I want to swim for my people. Mm. I want to show that, you know, this ordinary Syrian girl came here and is changing the world. Yeah, and I also wanted to ask you, how was it for you? First of all, you did not know how to swim.
No.
And that I find crazy, and I'm very, very proud, especially that you learned how to swim butterfly. And in general, just how was it for you just, you know, trying to get in the head of someone else and playing my role?
It was a whole journey, the swimming. So I had 2 months of training, of swimming. First, yeah,
I didn't get to train you though.
No, it's okay. Yeah, because she was training.
I was preparing.
For the Olympics.
Yeah.
I had a wonderful coach, Adele. I hope she's seen this. And she, because it was really hard at the beginning. I was like really not confident. Really, the first 2 weeks, I was really scared to not be able to achieve anything. But then you get into the water and you're motivated. I thought of Yusra the whole time. I thought about the fact that I really wanted to achieve it. And like you said before, you were not happy with the result. I was never happy about anything I did. So yeah. I wanted to always perfect everything I was doing. So yeah, it was training hard every day, 6 times a week for 2 months until I achieved everything I could.
Yeah, you told me.
So it helped me to get into the character. It helped me to understand how it is to be in the water. It helped me understand how it is to be a swimmer, how it is to want to achieve a goal in the swimming thing. And so, yeah, it helped me to understand you a lot. And I feel like I understood why you were kind of not maybe happy with the result and everything, because we always want to do our best. So it was a really good experience to be a swimmer.
I have one more question. What was like the one scene that brought you so much joy? Because we always say what was the hardest, but like I want to know what was one scene that brought you so much joy?
In the Olympics, while we were doing it, I had to do some strokes of butterfly.
Yeah,
and
I
was so proud of myself because I was not expecting myself to go that much. Yeah. So yeah, it's just...
Yeah, that's great. I'm proud of you.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully you enjoyed our conversation.
Hopefully you guys know us a bit better, and we hope you enjoyed the movie.